Welcome back to my channel. Today I am talking about something so new and exciting from MAC. I had a few requests for me to pick these up, and honestly, I wanted to buy them all, but I didn't. I had to, you know, simmer myself down and get three. What I am talking about are the new Spellbinder Shadows from MAC. I picked out these shades Mysterious Influence, what is this guy? Higher Power, and Dynamically Charged. So I am going to show you guys that, and I'm also going to do this tutorial. So if you are only here to see the tutorial, I will put right here the time that that starts so you can skip all the rambling. But I'm going to tell you guys what I think about these shadows. So before I do that, I'm going to tell you what MAC says about this on the website. It says, a shadow to create eyes with deepest, most mysterious shades that cling to lids like velvet. And I will say that these truly feel like velvet. It's amazing. Black ionized pigments are magnetically charged, fusing the powder together so it magically maintains its form and dimension. Features 8 shades in metallic finish. And its key claims is stay true color. So these pigments, if you know like MAC's regular pigments, they're just loose and they get all over the place. These are in here and like they don't come out. You sit here and you play with them and they still go back to this form. And it seems like it would like just fall out, but they just kind of go right back. It's really freaking cool. So let me show you the shades that I got. This one right here is Dynamically Charged, and this is the one that I have on my lids right now. Then I have Higher Power. Ooh, I love this one. It's so beautiful. And the last shade I got is Mysterious Influence. This is a little bit more of that green shade. Now, what I will tell you that I noticed right off the bat is that when I swatch them, they aren't nearly as pigmented as what they look like on the eyes, which is usually backwards. Usually when you do a finger swatch, they are more pigmented than they look on the eyes. So it's very, very opposite. MAC says to use this with their 24-hour extended eye base, and I do find that to be the best application. It does not look as good with the regular like soft ochre paint pot or stuff. If you set it with a bone color shadow, it doesn't work as well. It doesn't grab onto it. And then with the glitter glue, it kind of leaves like a harsh line. So I played with these a bit before I'm doing this review, and I did find that the 24-hour eye base was the best way to use this. Now, when I was doing my tutorial, I was getting flustered because I was having trouble with my camera. Did not want to focus. I kept having to switch back and forth with my eyes. So I was having trouble telling you guys what I was thinking because what I was thinking was more along the lines of what's going on with my camera instead of what I was doing. So let me explain something before we get into that. You do not want to put an eye base on and then set your eye base with a bone colored shadow like I typically do. You're not going to get the most pigmentation out of these shadows if you do that. So when you go in, it's going to be a little bit more difficult to blend because you're putting down the shadow and it's grabbing onto that base. So we go kind of backwards from darkest to lightest, and it looks like it's going to have a hard time. But if you just take your time and just keep going and blending, it's going to look just fine. Like, you wouldn't be able to tell that I didn't put on a bone color shadow before I did this eye if I didn't tell you. So just remain calm, be patient, and realize that it will be just fine. Another thing to note is that when you take one of these shadows and say you use a blendy brush and you just put it on your eye, it almost like just blends right off. So I like these best as all over lid colors and packing it on with something like the MAC 242. I wouldn't suggest trying to take one of these shades and then another shade and then another shade and trying to blend them, because I feel like they just kind of blend away. Unless you're using that 24-hour eye base and you're just really taking your time, I do like these the best as all over lid shades. Let me show you what I'm talking about. So I'm just taking this is a Luxie brush, and if I put it on my hand, you can see like I can almost just blend it away. and it's gone. So you have to have something to hold on to that shadow. And then I do find that packing it always works better for me. But on the same note, if you use 24-hour eye base and then you blend it over your eye in the same kind of motion, it gives it this almost wet looking washed out eye, and I think it is stunning. So it's kind of two different, very different looks. So if you want that color impact, you're going to want to pack it on, but I do suggest trying it. Just try it. Take a blending brush, make sure you have on your primer with no shadow to help it blend out, and just wash it over your eye. It is stunning. These are very different than the regular pigments. I can take pigments and blend them in there and they kind of still stay a little bit more true, but they're two different formulas and I think they're freaking incredible. And I can probably see myself getting a few more of these because I'm kind of excited about it. And then there's always the fact that it doesn't make a mess. Like, that's freaking awesome. I think these are really neat. I do think it takes a little bit of, you know, practice to play with them. If you're not used to it, it's going to be a little bit of like a learning curve, but they're amazing and I love them, and they are so glittery and shimmery, and I just cannot say enough. I love them. And also, because of how they kind of can blend away on just dry skin like that. And they don't blend away as much whenever you have a primer. So I don't know if I made that specific, but on just skin, it, when you get fallout, you can almost just like push it away. It's going to come off your skin. It's really nice. So anywho, if you want to see how I created this eye look, just keep watching. Taking a little bit of the 24-hour extended eye base from MAC. And I'm just using this conceal brush from Marc Jacobs just because my fingernails get in the way. You could totally put this on with your finger. I do have a little bit of soft ochre paint pot right up here just to clean up my brows, but I'm going to make sure this is all over. I'm going to grab Brulee out of the MAC x15 warm palette right here. I'm just using a MAC 239. I'm only setting right up underneath my brow because I want everything else to remain really sticky. And this is going to be quite different because normally we would take this all over and make it super easy for blending, but this is going to be a different technique, so just be patient with it. So I decided to go with Dynamically Charged. So this is the first shadow we are going to go in with. Now, I had already done this on this eye, but for whatever reason it decided not to be in focus, so I'm going to try this again. I'm just tapping this with the 242 on top of the extended eye base. And I'm just going up to the crease, but I'm not going to surpass it. Then I'm taking this shade right here on a 217. This is Divine Decadence. And I'm just going to start going very softly and very slowly right around the edge of that pigment. You just want to take your time because you don't have that shadow base like we normally would. So if you go too fast, you're going to overdo it. So just take your time and go back and forth, and it's going to look like a little bit more harsh than normal, but we're going to go in with another shadow. It's just we're doing things in reverse, so just take your time and it will work out just fine. Get the edge as smooth as possible. Once you've got the majority of your pigment off the brush, you can kind of start working it upward. But just realize that when we go in with our next shade, it will soften it up. We're going to switch brushes to the Sephora Pro Tapered Crease number 19, and I'm grabbing Creative Copper. We're going to see if I can go back on this eye or not. I don't know what's going on, but I'm taking this and I'm softening the edges of that last shadow we did. You can see how much softer that looks when we add that shade in there. It looks a million times better. So just stay confident and realize it is at the end going to look good. I'm going back in with that last shade, Divine Decadence, and the 217, and just deepening up the crease just a little bit more. And then also one more time with Dynamically Charged. I'm just tapping this on the lid. I just don't want to lose any of the intensity. And don't worry about fallout. This does wipe away a little easier, at least for me, than the normal pigments. Look how gorgeous. Lower lash line, I'm first going to go in with Creative Copper. Then I'm going to take this shade right here called Dance in the Dark. And I'm going to pop this right on this outer corner to kind of meet up with the other. By the way, I'm using a NARS contour brush. Same brush, but I'm going to grab Lemon Tart. And I'm popping this on the inner corner. Okay guys, so that is it. I did not add any liner or anything like that. I just put on mascara and then MAC 7 lash. I just wanted it to be really smoky and like kind of edgy. I thought it was so pretty. And then on my lips, I have MAC Verve. I have not worn this in a hot minute and I just thought it looked beautiful with this look. I will list everything else that is on my face down below. I hope you guys enjoyed this. Let me know if you picked up any of these shadows and what you think of them. And I will see you guys in my next video. Bye guys.